Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord. Brothers and sisters in Christ, good afternoon. Sa akong ingon kagalina, karong adlaw ay kaduhang adlaw sa akong Novena Mass. We are gathered together to honor our Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of Our Lady, Mother of Consolation and Sanctuary. The theme of our celebration is Our Lady of Consolation, Dawn of Hope, and Herald of Joy. The theme, brothers and sisters, expresses the profound roles that the Blessed Virgin Mary plays in the life of the Church and in our spiritual journey. It summarizes Mary's unique role as the Mother of Jesus, the Mother of God, and our Mother, the Mother of the Church, with a mission that is deeply rooted in the aspects of hope, joy, and consolation. And I would like to focus my reflection on the theme for our celebration. And I would like to share 3 significant roles of Mary, as mentioned in the theme. Mary, Our Lady of Consolation, the Dawn of Hope, and the Herald of Joy. Mary, Our Lady of Consolation. In our order, the order of Saint Augustine, we honor Mary, the Mother of Consolation, as the patroness of the order. And that is why this is a very special celebration for us Augustinians. In the Augustinian order, in the Augustinian tradition, Mary, the Mother of Consolation, was honored as Our Lady of the Sanctuary. Ang sanctuary, kung makita rin, ano yung sanctuary? Black belter sa among ipakos. So, si Mama Mary, the Mother of Consolation, was honored as Our Lady of the Sanctuary. Image, walay sanctuary. So it was believed that Monica, the mother of St. Augustine, sought help from the Blessed Mother. Then the Blessed Mother appeared to Monica wearing a cincture. Then she gave her the cincture as a sign of consolation and comfort. And so we have the image of the Mother of Consolation. However, in the Church, the Blessed Virgin Mary is honored and venerated as Mother of Consolation because through her, God sent Jesus, the Consoler, to the world. Mary's title as Mother of Consolation refers to her being the Mother of the Consoler and Comforter, Jesus Christ Himself, the Santo Niño. It is through Mary that she received joyfully the Lord Jesus, who is the consolation to all of us, and conceived Him in her womb and in her heart. Brothers and sisters, when we turn to Mary, our Mother of Consolation, in our times of need, she consoles us, not by taking away our suffering, but by drawing us closer to her Son, Jesus Christ. Mary helps us to see that in her Son, Jesus, our sufferings have meaning, and that they can lead us to a deeper relationship with God. We recall in the Gospel of John, where Mary stood by the cross of her Son, sharing in His suffering. Yet, she remained steadfast in her faith. Her example, my dear brothers and sisters, teaches us that true consolation is not the absence of suffering, but the recognition of God's presence in the midst of it. Our Blessed Mother always consoles us by guiding us to her Son and helping us to grow in faith. Second, Mary, the Dawn of Hope. The word dawn describes the image of the early morning light breaking through the darkness. It signals the coming of the new day. In the history of our salvation, Mary is the dawn of the coming of Jesus Christ, the perfect day. Mary's role, especially her participation in the plan of God, marked the coming of the new day. That is, the fulfillment of the hope of salvation. And that hope is realized in the person of our Lord Jesus Christ. We recall the story of the Annunciation, where Mary accepted the plan of God to be the Mother of God, to be the Mother of Jesus, the hope of our salvation. As we honor the Blessed Mother Mary as the Dawn of Hope, we are reminded that through her yes to God, hope entered the world in the person of Jesus Christ, the Dawn, the hope of our salvation. Mary, the Dawn of Hope, will lead us to the light of Christ, so that in Christ, God the Father of mercies and God of all consolation will comfort us in all our afflictions and sufferings. Third, Mary, the Herald of Joy. We recall the Gospel narrative from the Gospel of Luke about the joyful visit of Mary to Elizabeth after the Annunciation, where Mary received an announcement of the angel Gabriel that she would be the mother of our Savior. But after Mary heard the message of the angel, she went in haste to visit her cousin, Elizabeth. The account on the visitation of Mary is part of a series of joyful events which leads to the joyful birth of Jesus Christ. This is also one of the joyful mysteries of the Holy Rosary. Brothers and sisters, Mary was full of joy and excitement that she was in a hurry to share with Elizabeth her experience of God's goodness. On her part, Mary was full of good news that she could not contain it within herself, but had to share it. She visited Elizabeth, and that visit was done in haste, with a sense of urgency, because she wanted to share such a wonderful feeling and experience of joy in the Lord. More so, Mary, the herald of joy, it is because her presence brings joy as she carries within her the true joy, the true source of all joy, Jesus Christ. This reminds us, brothers and sisters, that joy is our inner response to God's presence in us. Joy is our inner response to God's presence in us. Like the Blessed Virgin Mary, this must be our disposition every moment of our lives, whatever life's circumstances. This joy comes from the knowledge that we are loved by God, and God is always with us. Brothers and sisters in Christ, today's celebration is an invitation for all of us to come to Jesus through Mary, Our Lady of Consolation, the daughter of hope, and the herald of joy. Therefore, this makes us aware that in our journey of faith, we are not alone in our struggle, in our battle against the many challenges, and in the midst of trials and sufferings in life. We know that we are not alone because we have our companions who will always offer us consolation and comfort. Our Lord Jesus, through the Blessed Mother Mary. In Mary, we find a mother who comforts us, a dawn who leads us to hope, and a herald who proclaims the joy of God's presence among us. As we follow the Lord more closely, as we continue our journey, let us entrust our lives to the maternal care and protection of our Blessed Mother. And we pray through her intercession that we may become channels of hope, joy, and consolation to one another. Amen.